Hello children, welcome to the online lecture of geography. Today we are going to study lesson number 5, ocean currents. Before we start the lesson, we should know what is ocean current. In familiar language, we know ocean current as waves. But ocean currents and waves are not same. So in this lesson, we will see what are ocean currents and their types and effect on the oceans. Okay, children? Let us do an activity. Keep a large metal tray on a stand. Fill it with water. After some time, the water will become still. Still means the water is not moving. Again, add some sequins. Sequins means plastic beads which you mostly see on the dresses of girls. That beads you have to add in the tray. You will notice that after some time, water is also not moving and the beads are also not moving if you do not disturb them, okay? After some time, light a lamp below the table. What changes will you see? What will be our observation? See children, it will occur to you that as the temperature of water increases, the plastic sequins move from one place to another. As the temperature rises, the density of water decreases and it becomes lighter. And therefore, the water having lower temperature, which is heavier, replaces the water with higher temperature. After some time, the sequins start moving in a circular motion. This movement of these sequins because of the flow of water. Children, density means thickness of water. So what happened? When the water is heated, as the heat is given from the bottom side, the water at the bottom will be heated first, correct? So as the heat will increase, this water, heated water will become lighter and will come up to the surface, top of the surface, and the water which was colder, that will go down. So because of this, as the change in temperature occurs, the water also moves from top to bottom and this gives a circular movement to the water. In case of ocean, the topmost water will be heated first, it will go down and the bottom part, cooler water will come up. Children, content of water is also important for density. If the salt content is more in water, the water will be more dense. Okay, children? A strange accident occurred on 10 January 1992 in the Pacific Ocean. A cargo ship was traveling from Hong Kong to America. And near Hawaii Island, the container full of toys broke and all the rubber toys started floating in the ocean. So children, what happened? A container full of rubber toys was broken and all the toys were floating in the water. After 10 months, on 16 November 1992, some of the toys reached the coast of Alaska. Some of them crossed the Bering Strait and by the year 2000, some of the toys were in the Arctic Ocean. Children, this map shows us the movement of rubber toys all over the water bodies. See, some of the toys have reached the eastern coast of America in 2003 and some were to the European coast by 2007. So how this must have happened? Yes, because of the ocean current. As we have seen, the movement of water because of temperature, because of change in density, the toys must have moved from one place to another. Ocean currents are of two types. Surface currents and deep water currents. Surface currents means the top part and deep means the bottomest part of the ocean. The region from sea level to the depth of 500 meter is considered to be the surface water. Yes, children, how much distance is covered under surface water? 500 meter. Because sunlight still can reach this depth. The movements in this layer occur mainly due to the difference in temperature and salinity. and the planetary winds give speed to the ocean current. What are the main reasons for movement in surface current? It is temperature, salinity, and the planetary winds. Because of the winds also, water gets movement. Surface ocean currents are also called as horizontal ocean currents. The flow on the surface of the ocean moves only 10% of the ocean water. Means surface ocean currents can make currents only in 10% of ocean water, that is floating water. The surface flow is considered up to 500 meters of depth. The discharge of water in the ocean is measured in Sverdrup unit. It is equivalent to 1 million cubic meter second discharge. Discharge of water means at a particular time, how much quantity of water is coming into the ocean. Okay, so how it is measured? It is measured in Sverdrup units. The horizontal flow of ocean water occurs as warm and cold currents. Means in the surface ocean currents, which type of current we see? Warm and cold currents. These currents flow from the equator to the poles and from the poles to the equator. See, this is the map showing you the ocean currents, horizontal ocean currents. The red one are the warm currents and blue one are the cold currents. So children, in this part what we have studied? We have studied what is ocean current, what is the reason for occurrence of ocean currents, and what are the types of ocean currents. They are surface ocean currents and deep ocean currents. Again, surface ocean current is moving up to the area of 500 meters. Okay. We have studied that ocean currents are formed due to differences in temperature, density, and planetary winds. Children, but along with these three reasons, there are also various reasons for ocean currents and their velocity. One of the reasons is rotation of the Earth. Because of the rotation of the Earth, the ocean currents move in clockwise direction in the northern hemisphere and in anti-clock direction in the southern hemisphere. Yes, children, in the northern hemisphere, it is moving in a clockwise direction. And in the southern hemisphere, it is rotating in a anti-clockwise hemisphere. This effect of rotation of the Earth is called Coriolis effect. What it is called? Coriolis effect. One more reason for occurrence of ocean current is continental structure. Continental structure means the structure of land. We know that the land is not even at all the places under water also. According to the alignment of the coastline, the direction of the ocean current changes. Alignment means the border of the coast. According to that also, the direction of ocean current changes. The velocity of ocean current is 2 to 10 kilometers per hour. Means in 1 hour, the ocean current can travel up to 2 to 10 kilometers. The ocean currents are divided into two types, cold currents and warm currents. Children, this cold current and warm currents, due to the cold water from the bottom coming to the surface and the warm water from the surface going to the bottom. Effects of ocean current on human life. Children, ocean currents specially affect the climate of the region having proximity to the sea. Means the places which are near to the sea are more affected by the ocean currents. In cold region where warm ocean currents flow, climate become warmer. Example, Western Europe, Southern Alaska and Japanese coast. Children, because of warm ocean currents, the place becomes warmer and precipitation increases. This is the reason the places do not freeze in winter in Western Europe, Southern Alaska and Japanese coast. In absence of ocean current, the ocean water would have remained still, due to which living components could not get food. Of course, if ocean currents are not there, all the water will be still. No movement can be seen in the water. And because of this reason, no plants will be able to survive. If plants are not there, food is not there for the animal. How the animals will survive? So fishes and all will also not survive in this place. In the regions where cold and warm currents meet, we get a lot of plankton and algae as fish food, and a thick fog is formed. Grand Bank near the North American coast in Atlantic Ocean and Dogger's Bank near the European coast. What they are telling? Where the warm current and cold currents meet, at these places, lot of plankton, fish food is available, so we can see many fishes at this place. And also one more thing is there. Wherever the warm current and cold current meets, in that places we can see lot of fog. Fog, you know, which we see in the morning, smoky climate. Because of that climate, many of the transportations face the problem of traveling in surface of water. These ocean currents are also very helpful for the transportation sources on water, like ships, boats. If the transportation is done according to the flow of ocean current, the speed of the ships increases and the fuel is saved too. So see how it is beneficial for the ships, that as the ocean current moves in one direction and the ship is also going in that direction, the fuel of the ship is saved. Near the coast where cold currents flow, the amount of precipitation is low. Example, Peru, Chile, and the arid desert of Southwest Africa. Deep ocean currents. These water currents are beyond the depth of 500 meters. These currents are formed due to the difference in temperature and density of water in different parts of the ocean. This is known as thermohaline circulation. Yes, children, what it is known as? Thermohaline circulation. That is circulation of water in the deep ocean due to change in temperature and density. These currents flow till the seabed of the ocean. They flow like rivers continuously below the surface of the sea. Children, the difference in temperature of various parts of the region is the major reason for deep sea currents. Warm water has lower salinity and density. Such water comes to the surface of the sea, and the cold water with high density goes down. This movement causes the deep sea water current. Children, we have seen that the movement of warm water and cold water is going on continuously. Thus, the redistribution of the ocean water keeps occurring. This redistribution takes around 500 years to complete, means it will take almost 500 years for whole water of the upper layer to go down and the whole water of the bottom layer to come up. This type of movement is known as Earth Conveyor Belt. Importance of deep ocean currents. Due to thermohaline circulation, movement of seawater occurs on a large scale. Because of this circulation, ocean waters move from the surface to the bottom and from the bottom to the surface. Warm water is transferred to the bottom from the surface, and the nutrient-rich cold water is circulated to the surface. Means what happens? The nutrients which are at the bottom of the ocean, that all nutrients are coming up to the top layer of the ocean.